permission of the chair, delegates are noted that a short presentation on XBRL by XBRL vendors are being held at room number C. Kindly take note of this. Now I call upon the moderator, CAK Raghu, to open the session.
Distinguished speaker of this session, Sri Piyush Goyal, Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha. Distinguished President of our Institute, Sri J. Ramaswamy, Vice President, Sri Jaideep Shah, my council colleague, Rajendra Kumar, and all the distinguished members present here. It is indeed a great honor and privilege for us to have Sri Piyush Goyal, a member of our profession from Mumbai, for having accepted our invitation to be here at this international conference. We extend a very warm welcome to you, sir, on behalf of all the delegates present here. This conference is being conducted in Chennai. We have delegates coming across the world, and this is being conducted in a magnificent manner. I would like to compliment the president and the entire team for the good work that they have done to bring all the international speakers to this conference. Friends, Piyush Goyal needs no introduction. He's an eminent parliamentarian, and he has been a member of our profession, graduated from the Don Bosco High School, Mumbai. He's a management consultant. He was a director, government nominee of Bank of Baroda from 2001 to 2004, member task force for interlinking of rivers, Government of India, 2002 to 2004, Director, Government Nominee, Government of India, State Bank on SBI from 2004 to 2008, National Treasurer of Bharatiya Janata Party, and has been elected to the Rajya Sabha on August 10, 2010 onwards, and currently is a member of the Standing Committee on Finance. I have great pleasure in presenting to you Mr. Piyush Goyal, who has been kind enough to join us today. The topic Piyush Goyal would be addressing is on financial sector, fulcrum of inclusive economic growth. I think all of you would agree with me that China and India are the two economies that are on the fast track of growth, and it is essential for us to keep in mind that inclusive economic growth is very critical for the success of any economy. The government of India is working very hard, thanks to eminent parliamentarians like Piyush Goyal, for the good work they are doing in ensuring that there is inclusive growth across the country. In fact, when we talk about inclusive growth, I think we as chartered accountants can play a very important role, because when we talk about economic growth, we also talk about financial inclusion. Today, the Reserve Bank of India, through the public sector banks, the private banks, are reaching out to rural India to see that there's total financial inclusion. Technology has been playing a very big role, and today we find that even in the small villages, ATM banking is there, mobile banking is available. Sir, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India is keen to partner with the government in any of the initiatives to bring about inclusive economic growth. And as you are aware, the Institute is conducting investor awareness programs across the country through all the 130 branches of the Institute to see that we educate the investors on the new schemes that are coming out and how their money could be kept safe. And I'm sure we will have a continuing partnership with the Government of India, and we are very keen to participate to see that we bring about total economic, inclusive economic growth in our country. With these introductory remarks, I would now request our guests to please address the members. And I would like to thank the organizers for having given me an opportunity.